Hello and welcome to the 13th floor. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, here with a board game bag check or cardboard coat check, where I am looking at a game that came out in 1995. That is Dragon Dice. The thing is, it's not 1995, it's 2003, and this is a new two-player starter set for the classic TSR dice-based battle game, Dragon Dice. And I assume there are people out there like me who are like, what? What? It's Dragon Dice? Dragon Dice is still around? Yes, Dragon Dice is still around. It has been resurrected and is still being produced, and there is still content, including a republishing of all of the original Dragon Dice kicker packs and expansions, as well as new sets. Now, I wanted to check out if this game lives up to the hype and my memory of it, the nostalgia. So here we are, 2023, about to check out Dragon Dice and crack open the two-player starter set and take a look at what you get. Now, I actually was a big fan of the original game, and I have a ton of the dice downstairs and the awesome leather-like TSR dice bags. I doubt we're going to get one of those in here. So this does come from a company called SFR. Is the company, and I do have to thank SFR for letting me grab a copy of this at Origins and bring it home to review, because I was so hyped. I'm like, you got to let me check this out. So here we have the new two-player starter set for Dragon Dice. Note, this wasn't released in 2023. This has been around for a little while. I just had no clue it existed. This came out in 2018. So it's not like it's new, but it's not 1995 old. All right, step one's going to be cutting the shrink. And I do dig it's got the old, you know, you have it in your store shelf on a rack. You don't see that much anymore for board games. You don't see stuff with rack tags. There, shrinks off. All right, the back's got a whole story here. It says, roll on to victory. As the battle for control of Elsfa begins anew, you take command. Dragon Dice is the game of fast-paced fantasy combat in which the dice are also your playing pieces, your army. The terrains they seek to control, and the fearsome elemental dragons bring the flaming might of the Firewalkers and the sturdy power of the Treefolk to your battlefield. Each race brings its own strengths, weaknesses, and powers to the battlefield. Use melee combat, missile fire, and elemental magic to seize control of the battlefield. The starter set has all two players need to begin their campaign. 28 six-sided dice, we'll show those off in a little bit. 4 10-sided monster dice, we'll show those off. 4 12-sided dragon dice, a playmat, and quick start rules. You can combine starter sets, add dice from Dragon Dice kicker packs or Dragon Dice expansion packs to expand it. Find out more, etc. I used to love this game. I'm excited to look at this. What I will note is not the highest quality packaging. There's already some like rubbed off because of it. But you know what? It's not going to matter. This doesn't seem like the kind of game you keep the box for. So here we have the Dragon Dice trademark two-player starter set from SFR. Yes, SFR Games. Oh, I recognize familiarity right away. The marbled dice look. There's your two different factions. You got two different bags each. Then in here, there should be even more dice. There should be the monsters and stuff. There we go. Some monster dice. Dragon dice. Multiple colors of dragon dice. Did we get 3? Yes, we did. Okay. Then we have, wow. Okay. Not overly impressed by this. The rule book. A little floppy there to fit it in the box. And what else? We have the play mat. So we're going to toss this aside. I'm going to start with the play mat here. Oh, multiples? No, for some reason I have 2 play mats. I don't know if it was supposed to have 2 play mats. So this is it. This is your board. Oh, yeah. You need 1 for each player. Okay. So they gave you 2 of the same play mat. I thought it was going to be 1 big mat. So yes, you have a play mat for each player here. Has their own. And what's interesting is different sets will have different terrain when you put them out. So this just shows where your dice go, where your different armies go. You got your 3 different flanks. So here's your play mat. There is a turn sequence summary and the resolution for magic missile and melee fighting. This is where your reserves go. This is where you're trying to summon monsters. And that's where people die, is on the ruined ship. So this is the basic play mat. You got two copies, both the same, for the core game. And again, it's not in the best shape from being squeezed into that small box, but I'm sure you can flatten that out. We're getting to the dice a minute, which is the highlight. We're going to flip through the two-player starter rules. So this shows off, get to know your dice, how the dice work, which again, I'll show you the dice in a second, how to set up the game. You've got the example showing both those playmats facing each other. And interestingly here, see, it shows one's water and one's trees, but mine came with two water. I actually think that might have been a mistake. I think I should have had two different maps, one for each, like the tree folk and the water people should have had two different maps. So that's surprising because you can see here that there's two different mats. But you know what? For gameplay purposes, it shouldn't matter at all. How to take turns. This looks just as slightly chunkier than like it's not a quick rapid fire game. How to march. The terrain die, which is this eight-sided die, the terrain die. And there's different types of terrain, and it's on the eighth face. So if you look, that is standing stones, whereas that is a tower. You can kind of see. You've got the various sides for the dragon, and then all the special icons off all the dice and what they do. Getting into various spells and how they work. It's kind of a meaty game. And then there's the symbols for the different dice that come in this set to show off your various characters. Now, if you do see these people at a con, they do have a better version of this rulebook that's not folded that you can get off them that'll be nice and flat instead of just in this box, which I should have had my copy out here, but I don't actually know where it is. So we're going to start off and show off the terrain dice. So these have various symbols on them, including, I should be holding this higher. Let's move this in. So you can kind of see the quality of these dice, and they're speckled, which is a neat look to them, with the various symbols on them. And this is, from what I remember, to actually go through the various phases of the game. And there are four of those for each of the different symbols. These two actually match the sets in this. This and this match the armies that are in this set. The dragon dice, I always thought were fascinating. Because if you actually trace it, you can like see the whole dragon in his back. And there's his two wings. So you can kind of see the wings there. There's his body. We're going to trace his body. There's a claw. There's the other claw. That might be a head. Sometimes they're a little hard to see exactly what the symbols are supposed to be. You've got the tail, body. There's a treasure chest side. That must have been the head. There it is. Okay, I now see a dragon head. Hopefully you can see as well. So that is one of the dragons. And it looks like all the dragons in this are the same pattern of dragon. So I always thought it was neat that like we have a different pattern on the green, and the green breathes fire. He's got different wings. So these two are similar. There's the fire on this one too. Were the wings the same? No, this dragon is definitely different than the other two. So again, tail, body, there's some claws. There's that. And each side you roll, there are the wings. Then you get the head. The two claws, the head. And breathing fire. So two that look like this, and then two that look like this. So there are your dragons. Then you get into your main units. These come in a variety of different dice sizes. So no dice bag. No dice bag at all. That is a change from the classic 1995 version. The classic 1995 version of this game came with these really nice dice bags to hold your armies. So the way you differentiate the unit types is by their heads, like the face side. So I'm going to try to find the heads for these various troops. That I think is it. Yep. So these are pretty far away, but I'm going to switch them all. So here is one baggie, and then you have this character, right? You see the head, and then there are various abilities, and there's magic symbols and attack symbols and so on the die. So this side represents which force it is. Note you have two of this character in this particular set who has, various lightning bolts and like finger, looks like casting a magic missile. Again, these are etched dice, which is really nice. Then you've got this princess kind of looking character. Got these two, which are actually different, but the same size. Dice kind of show off all the sides. I haven't played this game since probably 2000, so I'm not going to try to teach anything here. Just show off the various cool dice with the various symbols. And then this is a monster die. I'm not sure what monster that's supposed to be. It looks kind of nasty. And then the various monster attacks and symbols on that. So there's one half of that army. Then we have some more basic troops. It looks like they might match the same types. Sorry, trying to figure out where I put my... So we have a different monster here. So we have a different monster. And again, all of its moves and attacks. This is a different large size die. So I shouldn't have put the other way. This troop, looks like there's a couple of those. So that troop type. Two more of these, so four of those. Anyway. So two of these guys. Couple more of those. These neat looking ones. I think we had that one already. So that is all of one faction. The dragons. Then we have the green faction. I'll go through this one even quicker. That was the Firewalkers. And then this is the Treefolk. So the Treefolk, again, we have two different monsters. That's the symbols representing them. These don't show up on camera quite as well. But it's actually a really nice greenish yellow color. And the other monster looks like some kind of tree. Then we've got your large dice, and again, one side would be the character. These are actually the same tree folk. Can see them there. And then various symbols on these. These are mostly stars. There's also some walking. Couple more of the characters. And again, the sides match for this army type. Two more characters. And so on. I'm not going to hold up every individual unit dice. So, two full armies. Now, one of the things they have done to, in my opinion, improve Dragon Dice is there is no longer a collectible random rarity element to this game. So to me, that's one of the biggest advantages of this particular set. So here we have all the stuff we got. Looks like we did get a, did potentially get a mistake here with two of the same map. So there you go. What you get with the Dragon Dice 2-player starter set. You've got two armies to fight. You've got maps, battle maps to fight over, which should have been unique to each army. You've got the rule book. Everything folded up a little roughly to fit inside this box, but you know what? That's fine. Once you learn how to play, it should be fine. Now, one of the things you can do, and I'm going to show this off, is you can upgrade by buying a neoprene mat. And this is why I was not really upset that my maps were folded, because here you have a neoprene mat that you can get from SFF Games. I don't think, sorry, SFF is wrong. It is SFR Games. So neoprene mat for playing Dragon Dice on, which you got to say looks way cooler and nicer than the other one. So I did get a mat, which is why I don't really care that these are folded. So I don't know what army this is for. I just thought it looked cool. So I went with this particular one. So I'm going to roll this up quick. So there you go. What you have inside the box with the new still going version of Dragon Dice, some slight rule tweaks from the original, from what I understand, some rebalancing of the forces, 2-player starter set, everything you need to play Dragon Dice, a classic dice game originally from TSR, now brought back from SFR Games. Again, I do have to thank for letting us check out a review copy of this. Maps, dice, monsters, terrain dice. I know, I just love the dice in this game. Like, look, he looks like a little elf dude. I love it. And then the various symbols on the sides. Just something about that. I love dice, right? I'm a gamer. I have to love dice. So thank you for joining me for this unboxing of the Dragon Dice two-player starter set. Looking forward to checking this game out. I have the original. Another thing to note I hadn't yet is that this is fully compatible with all the old stuff. So I'm looking forward to tossing my old dice in with the new dice and having some fun with this game. When I do start playing this, I will be sharing my thoughts online, Tabletop Bellhop, one word, everywhere. I'll end up doing up a written review over at tabletopbellhop.com. And we'll also talk about the game on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. Thank you for joining me for this. It was fun for me. Unboxing video for this nostalgia trip. So going back to 1995 here in a way to check out Dragon Dice for the second time in my case, but checking out this new version from SFR Games. Thank you and game on.